Okay. Welcome to seminary. Jacob Michael is doing what must be done. Chase is on music share and personal share. Jacob Barr is doing the opening prayer. Addie is doing doctrinal mastery. Seekers are those who hunger. Teachers, the Holy Spirit, and the preachers, Brother Jones and Jaren, is giving thanks to God. Mark your reading. Chase. Send it.
What?
What?
Send it.
Am I just the only person?
Yeah, you're the only one who has a zero for reading.
Chase.
Everybody else has been sending me their things, so you gotta send that to me.
That's kind of embarrassing, Chase.
It's up to speed. If I asked you for it, you send it to me, you're okay. Some of them are updating their own by themselves. Chase?
That's so awful.
Get with it.
Seminary and institute.
Okay.
Answer the journal question, what miracles has Jesus done for me? Jake, you're on shares tomorrow, and Preston, you're on Friday. And today's my birthday.
And
Okay. More doors will open if you kick them down. I don't know. Okay. Today there's track, tennis, and the evening of excellence for those who are invited or those who want to support their friends who were invited. And tomorrow there's a Spanish festival. Yes.
Who's going to that? Oh, what time do you guys leave?
7 a.m.
7:15, actually.
Okay.
So we're going to have, raise your hands again. One, two, three, four, five of you. I'm blessed by
Does that mean that I'm going to have a sub in Spanish?
Yeah.
I'm good at Spanish.
Yes. That means six or seven of you won't be here tomorrow.
Yeah. And
yeah, small class.
Tomorrow. Is that boys or girls tennis at home at 4 p.m.? Jake, do you have tennis tomorrow? Or
today?
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Friday.
Okay, cool.
You can find one of them.
Thanks, Ivy.
I'm guessing one better.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Ivy. Sweet 16, a limerick just for you. If you don't know Ivy, you're lost. As a choreo dancer, she's boss. She'd never do harm, but outcompetes you with charm. Broken arm, still ran on, had to cross.
Mr. Joe, Brother Jones, you should be rapping for them.
Mister?
That's what I'm saying.
What?
No, I shouldn't.
Your rapper name?
That's the least close thing to rap.
I said Brother J. Brother J.
Wait, why did that one look
Yeah, Bro J. Bro J. Yes. Thank you for that.
Look how delicious this is.
All right, Chase. Your music.
Okay. I'm just going to play this song. It's a pretty funny song. I don't know.
Everybody, is this a sing-along? You know this?
Right?
Yeah. I'm gonna be looking for the message in here, the gospel message in this.
Yeah.
I'll try again.
Did we get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm
this guy just dissatisfied with life?
He's dissatisfied.
He wants more.
He needs more.
He needs more
life. Wish he had everything he doesn't have. All right then, Jacob Barr.
Our Heavenly Father, we're so grateful for the opportunity to be in this best day, and yes, that we can always save throughout our days, and yes, that we can be challenged with missionary opportunities, and yes, that we can be also protected and we say the same for us.
Thank you. Addie, or...
Okay, so I chose Luke 22, 19-20.
Quiz time. Luke 22, 19-20? Luke 22. What's Luke 22 about, guys? Raise your hand if you think you know. You take a guess on a quiz right now. That's worth 10 points. All right. What do you think it is? You're going to say that? Yeah? You didn't know? Few of us? Luke 22. Santa Cena. Okay, Abby.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. And he took bread and gave thanks and broke it and gave unto them, saying, "This is my body which is given for you, and this do in remembrance of me." Likewise, also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you."
Thanks. So, Chase, I'm going to move this over so we can see you.
So, that song, the whole thing is "I Wish I Was Taller and Like a Baller" stuff.
Keep going. Who wishes he had what?
6'4 Impala. And a bunch of other stuff. But he was not being grateful for what he has already. Like, there's one part farther in the song where it's like, he says he wants the 6'4 Impala, but he only has a hatchback and a spare tire in the backseat, but it's flat. And so he could be grateful that he has a hatchback, because I know a lot of people in the hood don't even have cars either. So he could be grateful for that. But just being grateful for what you have and not taking, or not being like, so, like, not spoiled, but, like, not being, like, wanting too much and, like, not wanting it in a good way. Just, like, you just want it to be cool. Mm-hmm. So.
Thanks for that reminder on gratitude. Everybody agree? I served my mission in Houston. My first area was called Denver Harbor, 5th Ward. Not 5th Ward like the church, it was called 5th Ward like a precinct. And that area, it was like, I don't know if I saw another white person the whole time. It was either on this side of the rail tracks, it's all black, and it's on the other side, it's all Hispanic, Latino. And it was one of the hardest gang areas in the entire city. And Houston is a violent city. And it was, you know, I'm like a farm kid from Idaho. And it was really, I saw a lot of things, and I saw the Impala was the car to have. The gangsters would, like, they're so, well, you see where they live, and then you see their car, and it's like, that thing is the most important thing. It's such a status symbol. The Impala just, like, slammed really low, or all on these hydraulics, and it'd, like, bump up and down and move all around, and super loud music, and you could just... There were drive-bys like around us happening, and all kinds of crazy things going on. And it was interesting, the whole culture of the status of having an object that means that you are something. Or like people would live in their car, but they'd have the most expensive Nike shoes or whatever, and they would kill you for your shoes, kind of thing. It's so important to have objects. And I think I like the reminder of that message, Chase, thank you, that we got to be careful about if we're feeling too attached to symbols that think something that we have our own makes us cool. It makes us something. Like that's us. Like in Idaho, when I grew up, having a truck, like the right perfect truck, that meant something about you as a person. Like my truck, you know, it's like my truck is me. And if I don't have the right truck, then I'm a nobody kind of thing. So yeah, very good. Jesus had a lot to say about that, didn't he? I don't know if you can think of any teachings of his or of his disciples about not getting too attached to material things, not having treasures on earth, things like that, right? So there we are. Any other announcements today? Zach's on here. Anybody else we missing? So, good luck today, computers. Do well, no injuries, hopefully. We're going to continue on with our shares. So Asher got chosen out of the bag yesterday, so he'll go first. Jaron's going to go second because he got picked yesterday and begged to not have to go, but that's all he got was a day. And then after that, we'll just keep choosing names until we run out of time. Please give your attention to the one speaking. Don't be trying to cram, prepare your own thing. When they say the verse, turn to it, read it, be engaged, be ready to answer questions, because, you know, what we want to do is get to know our Savior through the miracles that he performed. So don't forget, when you do your share, pick a word or a couple of words or a small phrase to you that helps us get to know our Savior better because of the miracle that he shared, and write that up here on the board, one of his attributes. Any questions about this? Open with this phrase. Hi, I'm Andy. I'm a repenting sinner. Don't forget to open that way. Tell us about the miracle, where it's found, what happened. Pick a verse that's powerful to you. What does this show us about Jesus' character? What does it mean to you personally? The fact that he did this then, what does that mean for you now? What statement of truth from this miracle that applies to everyone? And then see if you can invite us to learn more, ask us a question that's hopefully engaging. Then you're going to end with this specific phrase up here, the greatest miracle of Jesus Christ is the one that he's done for me. Good? All right, then. Asher.
Am I allowed to use the ball?
Sure. Just don't move around too much because then we're going to lose you.
Okay. Hi, I'm not Andy. I'm Asher. I'm a repenting sinner. Wait.
Hi, Asher.
Repeating.
Wait. Repeating?
No. Repeating sounds more funny, honestly. Okay. Now, I was going to choose the one where the woman touches Jesus, but somebody did that.
They did.
So, thanks. So instead, I chose in Mark 5:1-20. You should turn there. Because I'm going to call on whoever looks like they're not there to read. It's going to be really awkward. Mark 5:1-20. All right, Preston, can you read just in your head? Read it, and I'm going to ask you for somebody pretty soon. Okay. 5:1-20.
That's a lot of verses.
It's pretty short. Well,
you want us to read, skim this in our...
No, I asked Preston too.
Oh, Preston.
He's going to tell us about it in a bit.
Maybe he already knows it.
And that's what I thought, but that's why I'm going to have him read it, so then he can, so he can explain to everyone what he got from it. Okay, so now we all know where it is, right? Basically what happens is... there's this guy, and he's got, I think it says, like, a devil or an unclean spirit in him. And he's like, Jesus, I need help. Son, Jesus casts out the spirit. And the evil spirit or the devil or whatever goes to, like, a bunch of pigs. And then the pigs go and kill themselves in some body of water. And there's, like, 2,000 of them. And the rest of, like, the people are like, Jesus, go away. But
what I get from that is kind of a different side. I get more about the character of devils and of Satan, because it shows how powerful he is as well. I mean, 2,000 pigs, that's a lot of pigs. But I kind of like the way it shows how Jesus can overcome that. He can overcome, like, most anything. And I kind of like the way... Here, can you look, Preston, find the part where Jesus helps the guy?
What Preston are you doing?
Yeah. What does it say
just
exactly?
So, I think it's 13 where it says, and forthwith Jesus gave them leave, and the unclean spirits went out.
Mm-hmm. So this kind of shows it was obviously an powerful unclean spirit. I don't super know how to describe that, and I don't understand. But Jesus immediately deals with it for this guy, and it shows how powerful he is, and it shows how Jesus' character is one of caring. I don't know. This kind of, the dude asked Jesus for help. So if we ask Jesus for help, he can help us with whatever we need. And I think that's it. I don't know, or I guess a question. Jacob Michael, what's a time Jesus has done something for you? Do you want the ball? Do you want the ball?
As many times as happened.
Okay, one example. What happened in the last month?
Not in the last month. I'll just give you an example. One time when I was sick, I got a piece of blessing.
Okay, I'm sure we all have examples of that in our lives, and I invite you to ponder that. And the greatest miracle of Jesus Christ is the one he has done for me. Thank you, Jesus Christ, amen.
I need a word.
I can throw better. I can think of one word. Thanks. Because it makes you think of the story.
I don't know.
I don't know about that.
No.
No.
Okay.
Jesus is good.
Okay.
He is not.
Oh wait, I didn't see the Jesus is. I thought we were just talking about that. That's my bad. Yeah, I that.
You're on your next.
All my words are up there.
Smart.
Hi, I'm Jeremy.
I'm just gonna do it.
She's a little slow.
Ooh. Oh, wait. Yikes.
Oh, lovely.
Shut up, I'm dyslexic.
Thank you, Asher. Jared.
Hi, I'm Jared. I'm a repenting sinner.
Hi, Jared.
Hi, Jared.
Miracle I chose was Mark 1, 40 through 45. It was Jesus heals a man of leprosy. I was going to have Jake read it, whereas, and I'll kind of just like summarize it.
Mark 1?
Yeah.
40 through 42. And there came a leper to him, beseeching him, and kneeling down to him, and saying unto him, If thou wilt, thou canst make me clean. And Jesus, moved with compassion, put forth his hand, and touched him, and saith unto him, I will, be thou clean. And as soon as he had spoken immediately, the leprosy departed from him, and he was cleansed. And he straightly charged him, and forthwith sent him away. And saying unto him, See thou say nothing to any man, but go thy way, shew thyself to the priest and offer for thy cleansing for those which Moses commanded, for a testimony unto them. And he went out and began to publish it, and the two boys abroad the matter, insomuch that Jesus could no more openly enter into the city, but was without in desert places, and they came to him from every quarter.
Alright, so Jesus heals the leper, and I'm pretty sure he wasn't supposed to tell people, like, spread it around, and he did, and so much that Jesus couldn't even go in the city, and even when he was in the desert, people would find him. And I think he knew that he would tell people, and yet he still healed him. So this shows Jesus as grace for us. What does this miracle mean to me personally? That Jesus loves me. What statement of truth from this miracle that applies to everyone? Jesus loves all of us. What question could you ask to invite us to learn more? How has Jesus shown grace in your life?
So it's a call on someone.
How do you define grace in this context? How did you show grace to this leper besides healing him?
Showing that he loves him because he didn't have to do it, but he did it anyways. And he knew that people would come to him, and yeah, he did it anyways.
So even though the person did something that Jesus didn't necessarily want him to do, he's still
healed him.
He still loved him.
Mm-hmm. That was it. The greatest miracle of Jesus Christ is the one that he has done for me.
I love in that verse where he says, I will be thou clean. He wants to help us. Man, there's so much in these. So much. Okay, we'll wait for the next thing. Zach? It's your lucky day. You're not here. Ivy? Birthday girl?
Did we already do Matthew 17, 14, 15?
What's the story?
Jesus heals a boy with a demon.
No.
Brother Jones, it's a short day today.
Oh, it is. Thank you. Oh, I forgot. Thanks for reminding me.
Yeah.
We don't want to cut you too short. We'll be first tomorrow. Okay? Thanks. I was just having too much fun over here. Okay, so.
Yeah, I did say that. You guys are great. Thanks for your shares. Maybe what we could do, maybe the question that could be asked is, does anybody think or feel anything strongly about this miracle? Because I know that some of you have prepared ideas that maybe this one that you were going to share that's not, and you might also have something to offer that is meaningful. So how about if that question is, does anybody have anything that they know about this miracle that they feel is helpful? Or insightful. Okay? In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Closing prayer.
Heavenly Father, thank you for that we could all meet you today at seminary and hear the shares and quiz that we can get us today and have a safe walk back to high school. And in the name of Jesus Christ,
amen. Amen. Thanks. Thank you.